गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, सायराम, हाउ आर यू ऑल? आई होप यू ऑल आर फाइन एंड डूइंग वेल इन योर स्टडीज. सो स्टूडेंट्स, वी हैव कंप्लीटेड टू चैप्टर केस स्टडीज. आई होप यू ऑल विल लर्न थ्रू दिस वीडियो दैट हाउ कैन वी सॉल्व केस स्टडी. नाउ चैप्टर नंबर 3 इज केस स्टडी. वी विल कंटिन्यू इन दिस वीडियो. क्वेश्चन नंबर 1 इज, What motivates a host country to give entry to multinational companies? So what is its answer? The host countries gets many benefits from our MNCs. When a multinational company comes into our country, so there are many benefits which we get. Number one is like foreign exchange. So that is why they allow the MNCs to enter into the country. And the main benefits are like they bring new technology, the new techniques of management, competitive spirit and competition in the market, and foreign exchange. So there are many things which is very profitable for our country. Now next question is, name the organization which is formed by passing a special act of parliament or state legislation. Give the feature of such enterprises. So which organization is formed by passing a single special act of parliament or state legislation? And the answer is public corporation, like LIC, food corporation. So these are the corporations in which we when we want to open that organization, so a single act is passed through the parliament or any state legislation, then the government open that corporations. Okay, and its features, like it is governed by management, and management is controlled by the government, financed by the government. Its main motive is to serve people and as well as making profit. So these are some features of public corporations. Now next question is, state any three situation wherein government companies are most suitable form of public sector organization. So what are the benefits in this question? We have to give the answer that what are the benefits if we invest in a government company, or if we are having the shares of the government companies. So the three situation wherein the government company is most suitable form of public organization are: number one, where government wants to control a company without nationalization, means it is suitable when the government wants to control a company. Second, where government wants to go for collaboration with the private company, means if there is a private company and the government wants to collaborate with that company. Okay, so this is another situation. And third one, where the project require government planning and funds, like any making of dams. So private companies are also require the government companies to merge with them or to collaborate with them, because they want a government permission to make such plans. Okay, now next one is, identify the type of public sector enterprise on the basis of the following clues about it in each of the following cases, and also given an example of the same in the real life. So number one is, it does not hold majority shareholder by community, and neither does it accept any interference in audit and controlling and accounting from a government, but at the same time enjoys high dividend distribution to its member in the case of profit. So which type of public sector is? The answer is government company. The answer is government company. Next, it is the soul and heart of the government activities itself, with government accountability, means which organization of a public sector is the soul and heart of the government activities, which with the parliamentary accountability? And the answer is departmental undertaking. Departmental means like a like education department, railways, airways. So these are the electricity department. So these are the departmental undertaking. Next one is last one. It has its own constitutional code of conduct and registered under a special legislation passed by the parliament. And the answer is statutory corporation. We have already learned about it. Now, next question is, on the basis of the following picture, you are required to answer the following questions. So, the number one question is, identify the public sector to which the following organization belongs. And second is, state at least two features of each of the identified. Okay, so the features we have already learned, we have already knows about it. There are three type of public sector, like government, statutory, and departmental. And three common features or two common features of these departments are that it is controlled by a managed government, and it is also managed by a government and also financed by the government. And its main motive is to serve people. So number one is BHEL. BHEL is a government company. Its 51% share is under the government control. Next one is ONGC. ONGC is a corporation. Okay, it is a statutory corporation. Next one is the railways, that comes under the departmental undertaking. Next is statutory corporations, like this is a Bank of India, Reserve Bank of India. It comes under the statutory corporation, like SEBI, Security Exchange Board of India. It also comes under the statutory corporation and airways. Some airways are also comes under the statutory corporation. So these are the answer of that question. Now next question is, Post and Telegraph Department is the part of the government ministry. It is fully managed and controlled and financed by the concerned ministry. Okay, the annual budget of a ministry make a provision for a fund needed by a department. The ministry is answerable to the parliament for its functioning. So name the sector under which the Post and Telegraph Department comes.
It comes under the public
sector. So it comes under the public sector. And name the kind of organization. Is it also the concerned ministry? Means the type of public sector, departmental undertaking. Okay, next one is how the kind of organization to which this department belong in different from other organization in the same sector. So the answer is, how the kind of organization to which this department belong. So this the answer is also the departmental undertaking, the public sector, and three difference between in the all the organization in the sector. So all the organization, like statutory corporation, government company, and departmental taking, you have to differentiate them. Last one is, how are the revenue of a departmental treated? So the revenue is treated as it is deposited in the government treasury. Okay, now next question is, Post and Telegraph Department and Engineering Limited, India Limited, are two different kind of public sector undertaking. So according to you, how these two type of organization differ on the basis of management and control, availing business opportunities, revenue sharing, CAG audit, appointment, and status of employees. So first you have to find out that telegraph and post comes under the departmental undertaking, and Engineering India Limited. Look, student, where only limited is written behind the name of company, that means it is a government company. So you have to differentiate between them. Okay, I hope you all have understood. Okay, class, thank you so much.